Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Theo Joe, and I'm sure most of you by now have heard about Congress passing a bill that basically makes it legal for internet service providers to collect and sell data from their customers. And this is anything from web searches to your websites visited to your shopping habits or programs you might be using on your computer. However, ISPs do typically have opt-out options for some of this marketing data. And what I'm going to do is I'll walk you through how to do this on all of the biggest ISPs, no matter who you have. Now, as a quick background, if you weren't familiar with this bill that passed already, ISPs can now basically spy on you and sell your data to advertisers. This is pretty bad, but to be fair, it's not really as terrible as it sounds. First of all, the rules this bill repealed weren't actually even in effect yet. So ISPs can already do all this and probably have been for a long time. Secondly, it's not like they can sell individual data about a specific person, what they were doing online. There are other laws against that. What they basically are able to do is collect aggregate data that is supposedly anonymous and then sell blocks of this data to advertisers so they can advertise to specific groups. That might not make you feel any better, but the good news is that, as I just said, basically all ISPs allow you to opt out of certain data collections in one way or another. It probably won't stop them altogether, but it might help. And that's what I'm gonna show you in this video. I'll walk you through the process of opting out as much data collection as you can for each of the biggest internet service providers, and you can just follow along depending on who you have. Before we get to the individual ISPs though, there are a couple things you'll wanna opt out from no matter what ISP you have. And this is one thing you'd have to do for every ISP anyway, so this way I don't have to explain how to do the same thing every time. The first thing you'll need to do is go to the following website. It's optout.aboutads.info. And this is a site run by the Digital Advertising Alliance, or DAA, which is like an aggregate for a bunch of different advertisers. And it allows you to opt out of targeted advertising by all sorts of different advertisers in this group, which is over 100. When you go to this page, it will automatically check which sites you're opted out of, which is probably none. Oh, and you'll need to also disable any ad blocker plugins you have on at the moment, or if you also have the HTTPS Everywhere extension, you need to disable that as well because these will mess it up. After it's done, this will show you a list of all the different advertisers that may be tracking you to target you with ads. And you can just click opt out of all and it will do it. Keep in mind that this basically just creates a cookie in your browser that tells advertisers not to track you. So you will have to do this for every browser on all of your computers, and if you ever clear your browser history and cookies, you'll have to do it again. The other site you'll want to go to is optout.networkadvertising.org, which is for the Network Advertising Initiative. It's basically the same idea as the other one, just different advertisers. So click on Manage My Browser Opt-outs, and it will run pretty much the same tool that you saw before, just different name. And also don't forget to disable any extensions again that may interfere with this. Then just do the same thing, click Opt Out of All, and you're good. Now that you've done that, let's get into the ISP-specific instructions for how to stop them from collecting more data. And this data is often called CPNI, or Customer Proprietary Network Information, which is a fancy word of saying information they get from you when you sign up as a customer that they need, like your name, address, that sort of thing. So just remember that term, CPNI, if you hear me say it again. Now the ISPs that I research and will specifically go through are Comcast Xfinity, Verizon, both for cellular and internet, Cox Communications, Time Warner Spectrum, and Charter Spectrum, which are basically the same company, CenturyLink, and AT&T, also for cellular and internet. If you happen to have another ISP besides those that I just mentioned, I'll also include at the end some general instructions that should still help no matter who you have. And also, by the way, as I said before, I'm gonna put any links that I mention in the description also. So depending on who you have, you can just skip to the timestamps for that particular ISP. Let's go. First up, Comcast, aka Xfinity. You need to go and type in the following website. It's my.xfinity.com/add information. On this page, you may or may not see a button to sign in, but you'll definitely need to do that first regardless. If you're already signed in, you'll see a button that says opt out. So just click on that and it will say your opt out request has been processed. You may also wish to click the turn off email ads button as well. Below that, also click the link that says add choices. It doesn't really look like a link, but it is. which will bring up yet another tool for opting out of several ad data collection services. So once that comes up, just click select all and hit opt out. If you see anything that says something like can't be processed with HTTPS or something like that, it means that you have some extension that is forcing an SSL connection that you'll need to temporarily disable, like HTTPS everywhere. But either way, after you do that, just click submit opt out and wait for it to finish, and it will tell you if it worked. Finally, the next page you need to go to is the following address, xfinity.com/addservices. Now, unfortunately, I don't actually have an active Comcast service to access this page, so I can't show you what it looks like. But if you go there, according to the privacy policy, it should apparently have some more options to opt out of more things. So if you do that, you should be good to go. Now, if you want some more general tips that aren't ISP specific, you can skip to the last part of this video at this timestamp on the screen. This section is for Verizon. In their privacy policy, they have a section for how to opt out of using your so-called CPNI for marketing, which I mentioned before. Now, they list a few different ways you can do this, either by calling customer service at the phone numbers listed or by doing it online at the web address vzw.com/myprivacy. One thing to note though is that they seem to imply that that website will only work if you have a Verizon wireless service, and if you have residential internet, you might actually have to call them and request to opt out of having your CPNI used for marketing. Now, unfortunately, I do not have Verizon, so I can't show you what the opt-out page looks like, but I'm sure you can figure it out. So once you do that, you should be good, either going on the website or calling them up and requesting it yourself. If you want some more general tips that aren't ISP specific, you can skip to the last part of the video at this timestamp and I can talk more about it there. This section is for Cox Communications. What you need to do is go to the main website and then log into your account. Then in the top right dropdown, click on My Profile, scroll all the way to the bottom of the page, and then you'll see a box called Promotional Preferences. You want to click Edit Preferences and then check all the boxes basically, but especially the one that says do not sell my information. You really can't be more clear than that. And then hit Save Changes. Now we're not done yet. Next, you need to type in the following site again, cox.com/privacy request. And this will bring up more privacy settings. And this may or may not look the same here as what you see, depending on what services you have. In any case though, at least you want to click no for both of these options so they won't use your information, and then just hit submit. It should give you a confirmation, and now you should be good to go. If you want some more general tips that aren't ISP specific, you can skip to the last part of the video at this timestamp and find out more information there. This section is basically 3-in-1 for Time Warner, Charter, and Spectrum, which are all now technically part of the same company. Since I'm not totally sure which company's privacy settings work together after the merger, we'll just do them all. So no matter which service name you have, I recommend you try all of these, but it's possible that each step will still only work for the respective old company you have. So if you're using Charter and the Time Warner form doesn't work, don't worry about it. Anyway, it's not that difficult, so let's walk through it. First, you need to go to Time Warner's Spectrum site at this long address. I'll put the link in the description so you don't have to type it out. Now, this link was actually kind of tricky to find because they don't even list it in their privacy policy that I saw. But once you get on the page, it will show you a form for how to opt out of them using your CPNI that I mentioned before for marketing purposes. So you just want to fill that out and hit submit. Next, you want to go to the following site for Charter, pc2.mypreferences.com/charter/privacy. This will bring up a privacy preferences page that has a few links. We'll go through each one individually. First, click on the email marketing opt-out link. Then on that page, type in your account email and hit validate. Then we go back to the other page and click on the next link for targeted ads opt-out. Again, type in your email, hit validate. And then you want to click the third link for targeted TV ads. Then you got to type in the account number, not email, and click opt out. And finally, on the original page where it says opt out using account number, click yes, type in your account number twice, check all the boxes, and hit submit. Now you should be good to go. So if you want some more general tips that aren't ISP specific, you can skip to this last part of the video at this timestamp and find out more there. This section is for CenturyLink. So what you want to do is go to the following link, which is also in the description so you don't have to type it out. And this will bring you to a customer service form labeled Marketing Preferences. First, type in your phone number associated with your account. You basically just want to check all the boxes next, which will opt you out from several things, including marketing lists, call lists, mailing lists, and more. So fill out the sections with your address and email and all that, and once everything is filled in, just click Submit. According to their privacy policy, this should stop them from selling your information, which could include your name, address, telephone number, all that. So you should be good to go after this. If you want some more general tips that aren't ISP specific, you can skip to this last part of the video at this timestamp, and I'll talk more about that then. This section is for AT&T, both for wireless and home internet. Unfortunately for you, AT&T seems to be the biggest pain in the neck in terms of opting out of data collection, but I did my best to find everything they allow you to do. And this is all based on their privacy policy site, so if you want, you can actually look at that yourself, and the link is in the description. So first of all, if you happen to use the AT&T UVerse app on your phone or tablet, there's a couple extra things you need to do, because they use two services called Critterism and Flurry to track your usage within that app. To turn off the Critterism tracking, you open up the UVerse app, go to Settings, Diagnostics, and then set Enable Diagnostics to Off. I don't have UVerse, so unfortunately it can't show you what the steps look like, but that's what you need to do. I'm sure you can figure it out. Now for tracking with the Flurry service that they mentioned, well, the opt-out link that they provided seems to literally be broken, so I would honestly contact customer support and ask them to opt you out or how to do it. But those, again, are just if you use the UVerse app. Next, we want to opt out of another tracking service that AT&T uses called Criteo by going to their site, criteo.com/privacy. You scroll down a bit and then check the box that says opt out of all linked browsers and then change the opt out switch to on and also click the opt out button under Criteo's sponsored products. After that, next, you need to go to this address, att.com/cmpchoice. It will prompt you to log in and then take you to a page for managing your privacy. First, click on the tab on the left that says External Marketing and Analytics Reports. Then click Manage Your Preferences and just click the checkbox to opt out and hit Save. Then click on the other tab on the left that says DNS Error Assist, which you may or may not even see depending on what service you have. This may only be if you have the home internet. But if you do, just opt out of that again the same way. Next, click on the tab on the left that says Relevant Advertising, and it will reveal a few options depending on what services you have. For example, I just see wireless, so I click on that. And again, you just check the box to opt out of that and hit Save. The next tab to click is Third-Party Services. Now this one is tricky because it's possible that you actually may not want to disable it. They claim that this is so other services like your bank can verify your identity, or so you can get your location data if your car breaks down or something like that. If you think that you might actually use some of this, then perhaps you want to keep it on. Either way, what you would do is go to Manage Preferences, select a phone number, and then choose Allow Data Sharing or Not. And I honestly just kept it on in case I need it, but it actually says that no third-party services are receiving personal information anyway, so at least it tells you if something is using it. Now, finally, we've reached the final step with AT&T, which is to opt out of them using your CPNI, which I mentioned before, for marketing purposes. So on the same page, click on the tab on the left that mentions CPNI, and then click Proceed to opt out. You can also go directly to the page through the link here, which is also in the description like everything else. On that page, just put in your account number, your billing zip code, and then check the box to restrict the use of CPNI, and click Submit. They sure don't make this easy, but you now should be done. So if you want, you can stick around for the next section, which has more general tips that aren't ISP specific. This final section is for either if I didn't include your ISP, or if you want some general tips for how to opt out of data collection, maybe not even from your ISP, but other services. Most ISPs should have some type of opt-out settings, and oftentimes the magic word for searching for this is what I mentioned before, CPNI, Customer Proprietary Network Information. So if you Google, for example, ISP name, CPNI opt-out, chances are it will bring up some information on how to opt out of that. Also, it's important to know that essentially every website on the internet is required to have a privacy policy on the site. So if you go to your ISP's site, then look at the bottom of the page for the privacy policy link, and if they do have any options for how to opt out of certain data collection, that's probably where you'll find out how to do it. So do that if you want to check it out even more. Finally, you can do a very general search, and this could be for any service really, not even your ISP. You can Google something like company name opt out, just that. And I bet it will bring up some interesting things. Try this with any company you do business with, such as your electric company or your insurance company. If I had to guess, you'll probably find some hidden settings to opt out of things that they don't really want you to know about. So it's important to keep on top of these things because obviously they're not going to be very forthright and let you know that you can opt out of these things unless you look for it. So I think that should cover just about everything. Hopefully it was helpful to you guys no matter who your internet service provider is. And I'd love to hear what you guys think down in the comments section. Also, if you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. Also, be sure to subscribe because I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Should be worth it. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. So as usual, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.